With a little over 100 Lok Sabha seats left to go to polls, today is phase 6 of the 2019 Lok Sabha elections. And to discuss more about the polling and this phase, I've got with me our data scientist Rishabh Srivastav and Times of India's Kumar Shakti Shekhar. Rishabh, 59 seats are going to polls as we speak currently. Again, you know, lion's share was with the BJP.
This time round, there are going to be two real facets of interest. One, can BJP make further inroads into Haryana? They won the vast majority of seats already, but can they almost have a clean sweep in Haryana this time? And number two, the area of western West Bengal, the area that really borders Jharkhand.
This part.
That part, exactly. Can BJP make inroads there? Because the BJP does realize that it's not going to have its near-perfect performance in the Hindi heartland. It's relying on places like West Bengal to really increase its seat count there.
Shakti, do you agree with him? Because everything north of the Vindhyas, you know, everything is at stake for BJP because they literally won everything this side.
Yeah, BJP will have a, you know, a great challenge to retain all these seats which it had won in 2014 and also make inroads in West Bengal and Haryana.
So that's the double challenge of not just retaining but also making inroads.
Very true.
Since the focus is on Haryana, we'll start with Haryana. 10 seats going to polls. Rishabh, BJP still had 7 last time.
BJP had 7 last time, Sanjeev, but look at that vote share. Their vote share was 34.7%. And the INLT and the Congress, which have been the two historical competitors in this region, really ate into each other's vote share. Now, this time it's going to be super interesting because is Congress going to have a resurgence? Because they don't seem to have put in as much effort into the state of Haryana this time. And whether BJP is able to increase its vote share, because with the same vote share, it's not going to have the same performance this time around, because opposition vote is not going to be as divided as it was in 2014.
Shakti, very interesting, because another state where BJP had very little at stake, and suddenly you see that, you know, they've become the main player and the traditional parties have become floaters.
Yeah, and this might help the BJP, because had NLD and the Congress come together, they would have posed a great challenge to the BJP, but that hasn't happened. The BJP is still resurgent, it's trying to grow, and the anti-incumbency against ML Khattar is not as strong as it could have been.
We've seen that both INLD and the Congress have projected JAT leaders. Congress has Bhupinder Singh Hooda, Randeep Surjewala, and of course INLD is known for the Chautala brothers. I think because of the heavy emphasis on JATs in both these parties, we've seen that the non-JATs have come together under Manohar Lal Khattar.
When you have two parties competing for the same caste group, it's much easier for a new challenger, in this case the BJP, to consolidate all the other caste groups. And the BJP, to their credit, have done that to great effect. And apart from just the caste factor, BJP's rhetorical emphasis on things like sports, on other issues like just development of the state, on other issues like the construction of highways in the state, the entire peripheral road around Delhi, infrastructure, those things have put them in a good position in the state. Now, having said all of that, there could also be a general state of anti-incumbency amongst farmers, because that's the one group apart from Jats who aren't particularly happy with the BJP.
Thanks, Rishabh. Shakti, now can we discuss Madhya Pradesh? And this portion, 8 seats are going to polls today. This is the Gwalior, Bhind, Chambal region, if I'm not
wrong. As far as BJP is concerned, they are in a tough position in these states. For example, in these constituencies. For example, in Gwalior and Morena, these two particularly. Because Narendra Singh Tomar, the union minister, he has shifted from Gwalior to Morena. And they don't have a very strong candidate in Gwalior.
But if you see, BJP 53.9 and Congress was down at 35.7. And even in, Rishabh, if I can bring you in, even in the 2018 assembly election, the vote share was almost similar.
Those numbers are slightly misleading because, again, in that scenario, a 9% vote transfer from the BJP to the Congress would bring their vote shares at exactly the same. And we had very similar vote share numbers in the 2013 assembly elections as well in the same region. And we saw Congress completely dominate the region. One thing that's working in favor of the Congress is that Mr. Sindhia is very ascendant in this region. He is extremely popular on the ground. He's also very popular on social media. Although the one thing that might set them back is the fact that the loan waivers haven't gone as smoothly as Rahul Gandhi had promised.
Now to one of the more interesting battles happening. All the seven seats of Delhi are going to polls. Shakti, last time BJP had won all.
The Congress has fielded very strong candidates like Sheila Dikshit and Atishi by Aam Aadmi Party. They have also fielded
Ajay Makan.
So they are strong candidates. The BJP won't have a cakewalk this time.
Rishabh, last time we saw that BJP had really almost close to 50% vote share. And then the Aam Aadmi Party did a similar thing in the next assembly election. This vote swing, how does one go about gauging the mood on these seven seats?
I think Delhi is a state where you have a lot of swing voters, Sanjeev. And you have a very large caste amalgamation. You also have a very large array of professions, everything from traders to daily wagers. And we are likely to see a very large array of interests represented. Now, this time round, again, because there are groups, in particular traders, in particular daily wage workers, who aren't very happy with the BJP, we are likely to see a vote swing away from the BJP. But again, because both the AAP and Congress are extremely strong, a division of the anti-BJP vote might still see the BJP win a majority of the seats, though I agree that they probably wouldn't have a clean sweep again.
Let's move to the next state, the crucial state of Uttar Pradesh. Total of 14 seats are going to the polls. Rishabh, these are more in the eastern part of the state, and BJP again had won 12 out of the 14 last time.
They'd won 12 out of 14, Sanjeev, and their ally partner, Apna Dal, had won another.
That's Pratapgarh.
That's Pratapgarh. Now, this time, and you would, of course, know about this much better because you recently interviewed Raja Bhaiya. So I would love to know what your opinion of the region is.
See, it's going to be a tough fight. It's not as easy as it looks if you go by the scorecard here in terms of vote share. Azamgarh, again, we have Akhilesh Yadav contesting. We have to see how good the combination works of SP and BSP. If you just look at the number of votes, yes, the number of votes of SP and BSP is very high. They can be in a winning position. But on some seats, the candidates and just the sort of campaign that has gone about, that has made it a bit lackluster for the Mahagathbandhan. So it will be an even fight between the two sides.
Yes. Basically, it will be seen whether the arithmetic or the chemistry or both work.
SP and BSP combined had a 47% vote share in this area, compared to about 35% for the BJP. Now, that is a sizable lead, and the arithmetic is extremely strong in the Purvanchal region.
Let's go through West Bengal before we wrap up the show.
Now, West Bengal saw a complete and utter collapse of the left in 2014, and the primary beneficiary of this was the Trinamool Congress. Now, the Trinamool Congress won all eight of these seats. They had almost half of the vote share. But what the BJP will be hoping for is, one, if it's able to polarize the electorate further in order to get some of the Hindu Trinamool Congress vote onto its side. And two, they'll be hoping for a further collapse of the left, a further collapse of the Congress, and hoping that their votes come into the BJP fold.
So thank you both, Rishabh and Shakti, for joining this conversation. We're witnessing a tough battle between Narendra Modi's BJP and Mamata Banerjee's Trinamool Congress in West Bengal, as 59 seats are going to polls in phase 6 right now in 7 states. Thank you so much for watching the show, but do stay tuned in for live updates.